Here, the only values of m that make the inequality true are in interval 2, the numbers between negative 2/3 and positive 5. In the first interval, we can test a number that's less than negative 2/3. Well, negative 1 is less than negative 2/3. We know this since negative 1 can be rewritten as negative 3/3. We want to plug in negative 1 instead of negative 3/3 since it's easier to work with an integer than it is with a fraction. Substituting the value of negative 1 in for m, we get the inequality statement that 6 is less than or equal to 0. We know this isn't true, so interval 1 is false. Next, we want to test the value in interval 2. I think the easiest value to test in this region would be 0. When we plug in 0 for m, we lose these two terms to get negative 10 is less than or equal to 0, which we know is true. So yes, these values can be included in our solution set. And finally, we test a number in interval 3. I'm going to use the number 6. You could, of course, use other numbers. 10 would have been another great one to use. Plugging in 6 in for m, we'll get the inequality 20 is less than or equal to 0. This isn't true, so we know that this part is not included in our solution set.